26. Matter of fact, 27 made me feel a little bit better. When you got it, say, I got it.
I got it.
Matthew chapter 16, verse 25 through 27. I'm reading from the New King James Version. Let the words of my mouth and meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. Lord, you are my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. For whoever desires to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. For what profit is it to a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for his soul? For the Son of Man will come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and then he will reward each according to his works. Matter of fact, let me read verse 28. Assuredly, I say to you, there are some standing here who shall not taste death till they shall see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. For a few moments, I want to talk from the subject. Don't lose yourself trying to win yourself. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Don't lose yourself trying to win yourself. It is very troubling in this time where many of us, we are chasing after material gain. And the world has not made it easier with all of its creative devices, and all of its new ideas of modern technology, housing developments, and car developments. It is very difficult not to have an eye for material things. So, as we are in this world, but not of the world, there is a warring in our spirit that causes us to chase the ideology, the thought process of the world, that can cause us to lose the very essence or the very thing that helps us to maintain the things of the world.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that there's nothing wrong with material things because I like nice things. But oftentimes we've seen people lose themselves in gaining so much worldly possessions till they forget about the very thing that allowed them to actually get the possession of that thing. Even as the Lord has spoke to me, that this is the year to obtain it all, everything he promised you, everything that the devil stole from you. He said that this is the year for you to obtain every single thing that I promised you. But you cannot lose yourself anticipating and waiting for the material gain that God has said that he will give to you in your life if your soul is not right. Not only is your, so if your soul is not right, but I've come to understand and realize that you have to have this mind to be in Christ. So that you're able to maintain the blessings of the Lord that make it rich. And addeth no sorrow. I don't know about you, but I'm ready to receive those blessings of the Lord that make it rich and addeth no sorrow. Because you know when you get things from other people. I ain't talking about everybody, but there are certain people that give you things. Every time they give you things, they got to remind you about those things. And it feels as if it's a weight on your shoulder. Why did I even get this from you if I had to hear it from you every time? That's when you can really know and tell who's for you. And who's really against you. Who has your heart and who really don't want to see you make it. Who's really in your car.
All right.
When trouble comes your way. Y'all will talk to me here today. And I've come to realize that oftentimes when things come in our lives to help shift us or position us, it will allow us to change the dynamic of not only how we pray, but how we talk. As we look at this text in the book of Matthew, as Jesus is telling them and teaching them in the red words, he's telling them, I don't want you to gain the whole world and to lose your soul. But before we get to that, he is dealing with telling Peter and the boys, he asks the question, who do men say that I am?
Right.
But some say Jeremiah, some say one of the prophets. Jesus said, no, I'm good, I understand all of that, but I want to know, who do you say that I am? Y'all been hanging with me for a while, so I want to know, do you really know me?
Yeah.
I want to know, do you really know who I am, or are you basing your relationship with me off of what somebody else said about me? Ain't nobody talking in here. And the problem us, we have relationship with individuals that are well, good, and fine, but when we get around other people and they start talking about that person, it changes our perspective about them. Ain't got nothing to do with you, but just what you heard. You got to be careful of what you heard. What I heard is that they say. He say, she say, they say. But what do you say? Because if you're my real friend, you will talk up for me when people start talking about me. If you're down with it for real, when people bring up my name, you'll say, hold on, you ain't going to do that right here. Not in front of me. If people stop talking about your pastor, you'll say, hold on, you ain't going to talk about my pastor. I'm playing by my pastor now. Now, you have a problem. You go, no. I can talk about my brother all day, but you ain't gonna say nothing about it. He's there, and he asks the question. He said, what do you say? Peter, he steps out, he says, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. He said, flesh and blood could not have told you this, but my Father, which is in heaven, he said, you caught this revelation. I was amazed in this moment. He said, Peter, he said, upon this rock, I'm going to build my church. I ain't talking about this building, but I'm talking about your spirit. Upon this rock, I'm going to build my church, and the very gates of hell shall not prevail against you. Because once you have me on the inside of you, I don't care what comes your way, it won't change your perspective about who I am. And you won't be trying to run after material things, but you'll keep running after me, no matter how hard it is. He says, whatsoever you shall God. And he said, and I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever you lose on earth will be loosed in heaven. He says, I need for you to get in your mind to speak those things of God, to understand the power that you have on the inside of you. After he gives Peter all of this credit, after he gives Peter all of this glory, he begins to share with them a most intimate part about what he's getting ready to go through. He predicts his death, and he shares with Peter there. He said, from this time on, Jesus began to explain to his disciples, I must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things at the hands of the elders, chief priests, the teachers of the law, and that he must be killed, and on the third day he will raise to life. God help me today. Oftentimes when you tell people things, they don't know how to comprehend it. They don't know how to receive it. Y'all will talk to me here today. And so sometimes people will take what you say and they'll take it and spread it around. There's some other people, some y'all will talk to me here today, they'll add on to what you say. All I was trying to do is just let you know. God will tell me what God was doing in my life, but you're trying to mess some things up that won't help you. Y'all will talk to me here today. In the time, I wish I had somebody to hear what I'm saying. Peter was trying to stop the very thing that was going to happen in the future. And all the time we get caught up, y'all will sit under me here today with what we see, y'all, what we see in front of us, and we don't see that in the future it's going to turn around and bless us. I can't hear nobody talking to you. That's why you can't be discouraged in the midst of chastising. My chastisement, why you want to chastise? Let me know what I'm doing wrong. In the future, I'm going to mess up. Tell anyone about this. And Peter, the very one that had just got through saying that he was who he was, the very one that was with him, that was down with him, he said, took the sides, and he said, no, Lord, this shall never happen to you. Jesus turned, said to Peter, get thee behind be saved.
Right.
That's what I want to focus on just a little bit. That when people come to you to try to change your perspective about your God and where God is taking you, the dreams that God has shown you, the conversations you and God have had, you need to learn how to tell people to get thee behind me. Get thee behind me, say, to talk to that spirit that's sitting in the middle of them. Because all that is a spirit. When something that comes around, you start doubting. Y'all don't talk to me ahead of that. That ain't nothing but a devil or a demon that y'all gonna say to me. Can't see what God is trying to do. And I came to tell somebody, I don't need for you to lose yourself trying to win the popularity of people. That's number one right there. That's number one. That's number one right there. Don't lose your mind trying to win the popularity of others. Then Jesus said this, if anyone desires to come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever desires to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. He said, I want to tell him, don't lose the mind trying to win the popularity of others. And Peter, he started shaking himself, you ain't got to do this. And sometimes when people tell us the things that we ain't got to do, y'all will talk to me, those wicked vices, people try, ain't nobody giving you no godly counsel. All they doing is trying to give advice, y'all don't say that to me here. That ain't got nothing to do with the Spirit of God. If you ever get in front of people and you sharing it with them what God is telling you, and they ain't giving you no word, ain't saying, I'm gonna pray with you, I'm gonna leave my faith with you, but tell you, girl, I don't know about that. I don't know if that's gonna work. God will help me. I want to talk to the young people a little bit. Don't you allow the people at your school lose your mind trying to be popular and trying to be accepted about some kids that don't even know who they is yet. I know that's not popular. They don't know who they is. He says in Romans chapter 12 verse 2, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of the mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Galatians chapter 3 verse 2 says, set your mind on things above and not earthly things. I had a service the other night, and I went to go and share with some friends, and I was in my area, my hometown of Hartsville, and I stopped by a restaurant, take them out to eat after service. Applebee's, local Applebee's there, and we're sitting there, and I see everybody, hey, what's going on? You know, I go home, but when I go home, I go in and out, I go to mama's house, and I go back where I go. And when I got there, I'm speaking, hey, how you doing? What's going on? So I'm sitting there, and I'm speaking to one of my neighbors, and one of my neighbors from used to live across the street from me.
Yeah.
And she was saying, oh my God, we're so good, grown up. Look, I'm so proud of you. My mom used to always say, you know, you were going to be a preacher. I said, okay, yeah. She said, you don't know if you remember this. I said, no, I don't remember because I really don't. I remember going outside and playing some things and some things don't. And she was saying, I remember, you know, you would get up on Saturday mornings and you would run to the front of the mailbox, to the mailbox, and you would just be singing away. You would just be saying, I don't know what you were saying, but you were just in your own world.
Yeah.
And I said, what do you say? She said, my mom always said, look at it, y'all laughing at him, but he's going to be a preacher one day. And so, as I was sitting there, I was thinking about all of my life since then, as I'm talking about singing, I could be in the car by myself and I'd just be singing away.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I don't care who's looking at me. I don't care who bumping their horns. If, you know, I get caught off. Okay. I keep my mind. I talk to Jesus daily.
That's right.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
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 I ain't got to wait to pray me.
Every day.
All right.
Because I'm talking to him daily.
Every day.
Because I got him on my mind. Y'all have talked to me every day. Whatever it takes to get Jesus on your mind. I can hear nobody say, whatever it takes to get him on your mind. Whether you got to pop that old cassette in, whether you got to pop that CD in, whether you got to go to Pandora and just put it on Pure Gospel. I just want all of these insects. Whatever you gotta do to deny themselves.
Yeah.
I was in high school as I really started changing my thought process, changing my ways. I was in high school wearing button downs, loafers, and slacks and shirts like that. Slack pants on it. Right, and you know, coming up, I had some trouble because I was trying to please the crowd. People say I was bad and all that, but you know, people, you know, kids are cruel.
Yeah.
Pick on you, they say all kind of things, and that's fine. That's good. They're just expressing themselves. They don't know how to manage it right now.
That's right.
They grow up after a while. But I used to make just choices, make decisions, and out of those choices and decisions, people call me bad. But after I said, you know, no longer do I want to do this, you know, Lord, I want you to, whatever you want for my life, that's what I'm going to submit to. Yeah. When I started doing that and changing the inner core, my outer core began, my presentation started changing.
That's right.
So when I walk in high school now, the principal, instead of calling me William, he used to call me, how you doing, Mr. Robinson?
Yeah. All right.
Y'all going to say that to him? Yeah. When you change the inner core, which begins to proceed to change the outer core, it'll change your name. Y'all gonna take some of your name. I wish I had some Jacobs in here and realize that their name can be changed from that. So they begin to change, kept the influence. He said, don't lose your mind trying to win the popularity of others. He said, not only this, he says, tell them, don't lose your morals.
That's right.
Trying to win the morale of the world. For what profit is it to a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for a soul? So that's the question he's asking you. What is going to profit to you for you to have all of these things?
Yeah.
Lose your morals. You know you know right from wrong.
That's right.
But you're going to lose your soul. And make a choice, make a temporary answer or a choice for something that can destroy your life for eternity. Yeah, well, I got money. That's fine. You know, money runs out. You know
that. That's right.
Yeah, dude.
And if everything came and got blew up from it, I'm talking about scattered and ain't nothing. I'm talking about if it was a disaster that happened, God forbid, and all of us survived.
Yeah.
Ain't no banks, ain't no grocery store, ain't nothing. The system, they just shot out the satellites in the sky. Information gone and lost. You can't even check your phone or check your bank account because it's destroyed. What you gonna do then? Boom.
Right.
So I don't want to wait to get to a point to where I got to change my mind in a disaster when I can have my mind already together so that in the midst of a disaster I can still shout about. You hear what I'm saying? Because as long as you got breath in your body, you still got enough.
Watch out.
Got to be careful of the company that you hear. Oh, for you say that. They still say that. That's your mama and grandma. They used to laugh too. Your grandma don't tell her she's talking about. Better watch the company you keep, baby. If you ain't found out yet, you'll find out later.
That's right.
And the people you started out with are the people you might not end up with. Ask Jesus. Let's ask Jesus for a minute. He started out with a multitude of disciples that condensed down to just 12. And by the time he got to the cross, I can hold this right there. I'm gonna say that. By the time he got to the cross, he couldn't find nobody. Nowhere. Be careful of the things that you say and do and where you go. Thank you, Harley. He said, don't lose your morals trying to win the morale of others. He said, don't lose your mind trying to win the popularity of others. He said, last but not least, I'm getting ready to go. He said, don't lose your promise trying to win the props of Satan. For the Son of Man will come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and then he will reward each according to his works. Surely I say to you, there are some standing here who shall not taste death till they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. If you remember, if I can elaborate just a little bit, you remember when Jesus was in the wilderness, in the desert, for those 40 days and those 40 nights, and Satan comes to him in the wilderness while he's going through his process of being cleansed, of being purged. He's going through his process of fasting and praying. He gets hungry. Some of you have gotten hungry in the process. And the devil has come to bring you stone and tell you to turn it. Y'all gonna say that to me here today? So you can get off your fast, so you can get off the process. He's trying to get you to turn. No. Tell Jesus, he said, listen, I'll give you, look at the view.
All of
it. I'll give you all of my kingdoms. You know that everything we see, all of these things, are just props. Now you get this fire, that's a prop. Props on something. You do know this building is a prop. You do know your house is a prop. You do know your car is a prop. You know this land is a prop. You know money is a prop. What you telling me? You telling me, how you gonna tell the very one that created everything? I made all of this. I did all of this. You trying to give me what I already created or what I made? You trying to give it to me? How foolish are you? So when people bring you stuff that you know God is already, don't say that to me here today. Why you gonna sit there and allow them to speak you into something that you know already God has already taken care of? Say, don't get caught in these props and lose your promise, because you can take advantage of something that looked good for right now and miss the very thing that God did that was bigger than that little thing that you got temporarily. Okay, man, he says, I was talking to him yesterday, actually. It was funny. Doing some work yesterday, and me and brother was working together. He was laughing. He said, man, I tell you, I got a 19-year-old daughter. He said, man, look at this tape. Show me the tape. I said, wow. He said, yeah, she want to drive my car. She want to drive my Lexus. And I told him, no, you ain't driving my car. You ain't driving my Lexus today. And she said, she got mad. She said, no, I ain't. She didn't want this. I said, remember I told you to clean up the room. He didn't clean up the room. He said, nah, whatever. He said, watch this. Now, what he was setting her up for is he has an older model Lexus, which is still in good condition, looks good, but his sister just bought a brand new 2017 Lexus, I forgot the series, and it was sitting black, I mean, loaded out, and he was going to, you know, get the sister was going to let her drive the car. She said, she laughed out there, you know, the emoji. And says to him, she said, whatever.
Okay.
He says, watch this. He said, she gonna really be proud when I show her this. What she was gonna drive. You gotta be careful. Or what you laugh at God about. And the process he's taking you through. He's just trying to see how much patience you got. To receive the promises that he has. Waiting on you. You know it takes time to make something good. Takes time to make something great. Takes time to make something grand. Y'all gonna say something to me in there? It took them a while to make that big grand Titanic. Even though it's something.
Oh, Lord.
Pops. Jeremiah 29:11 says, for I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. God has already laid out a plan and a promise for you that you shall not fall, you shall not fail, but you shall receive it all. I can't hear nobody say that to me. He said in Matthew 11:28, he said, come to me, all you who are weary and burdened. I know you've been struggling. I know you've been straining. I know every time you look around, it seems like there's trouble on every side. He said that I will give it. He said, bring all your burdens unto me, and I'll give you rest. He said, take my yoke upon you and learn from me. You got to learn from your mistakes, baby. Stop being pitied and petty, and stop being wallowing in your sorrow. You got to learn from your mistakes. You got to understand that there's a teaching moment in your life. I can't hear nobody saying nothing here. Joseph C. Smith can teach you what God can teach you. And what I came to tell you, I learned one thing. I remember Dr. Nichols, God bless his soul. He said, everybody think education is the school. Everybody think education is Joseph C. Smith, Vance High School. He said, but that ain't education. He said, all that is a school. He said, education is life itself. And God will teach you some things if you just pay attention to your life. If you can think back, oh, talk to me here. If you can look back over your life and think about the things that you've been through. If you can think about the choices that you made that caused you to fail the first time. If you're trying to do something different and ask God to help you this time around, he'll open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing you won't have room enough to receive. I came to tell somebody in here today, don't get caught up in the props. Don't get caught up in people. Don't get caught up in popularity. He said, well, I want you to make sure that your soul is right. Once your soul is right, then your mind can be right. Once your soul is right and your mind is right, your talk will be right. Once you talk to yourself and hear the word of God, it'll begin to change your mind. That'll begin to turn your wheel to do what God has called you to do. It'll turn your wheel to do what he said. And I guarantee you, if you seek ye first the kingdom of God and all of his righteousness, he said, all those other things again. I don't want to be another statistic that God and lie at the same time. I know it sounds funny, but I'm not talking about statistics such as the number one cause of death. Young black men, 15 to 34, murder. 93% of murder victims were killed by someone who has shared their race. I'm not talking about those statistics, even though we need to know them. But I'm talking about the unaccounted for statistics. Even though, yes, Lord, I'm talking about the unaccounted statistics of souls who die and lie, saying they were saved and had a relationship with the Lord.